I'm the lures out here on the Clarence River. I use a number of different styles of lures and different strategies depending on what I'm targeting and what the situation dictates. At the moment, I'm just bottom bashing gulp shrimp actually. You might see there my rod tip is getting nipped. I've had a few bites so far just in this area, but haven't managed to hook one here yet. I've also got a hard body lure tied on. I've also got a blade tied onto another rod as well. And I do a bit of trawling from spot to spot, but most of the time I spend my time flicking at the suspect areas. Getting very tentative bites, but no solid strikes. So I'm gonna resort to a tactic. Putting on some tasty pasty a scent, and I don't really have a clear favourite. Well, I do actually, and that's this Dizzy Borg's garlic scent. And the only reason I like the garlic scent is I find it a lot less offensive to me personally than everything else out there. Whether it's any better for the fish or not, I really don't know. So far, my experiments would suggest not.
Hooked a nice fish here. Went for quite a run when it first hit. Doesn't feel all that heavy now though. Out here on the Clarence River today. Mighty Clarence. Fantastic fishery. I'm less than 100 metres away from my door. Don't know why I don't fish it more often. Very muddy at the moment. Doesn't look like there'd be fish around, but there is. It's a nice fish, whatever it is. It's a bass. Bass whacking. Pretty good bass, I think. My bass standards. Look at that. One of the better fish I've hooked. Beautiful fish. He's going back. Nice. Goodbye, buddy. Hooked on with a blade here. Feels like a bream, which means it's probably a flathead. Two casts, two strikes with this lure out here. Yeah, it's a bream. Come here, little buddy. Those bream are suckers for those vibe lures. Just suckers, especially around here. Just a little one. Another bream. Oh yeah, I'm on. Feels like a good fish. Oh, is it still there? Yeah, it's still there, swimming towards me. I'm going for flathead. Stopped the jerk and it's just swimming. The water's so muddy I can barely see it. Not a terribly big one either. Flathead though.
When I say just, that's not a bad thing. That's what I came for. But it's all I expected to find. I can't see them because the water's so murky. Yeah, that's a better size. There you go, viewers, there's dinner. Nice plump flathead. Absolutely perfect for the fry pan. But be careful of these guys. They've got nice big spikes on their heads. And if they dig into you, they bloody well hurt. Which is why I'm using these lip grips on the fish. Making it a lot easier to manage the thing. I only ever use that on fish that I intend to keep generally, unless I absolutely need to, because they can't hurt the fish. Got another flatty here. That looks very big. Might be worth keeping for the table. Oh, it's pretty dark now, so it's hard to see. You saw me. It's actually a bream. Fell for the Gulf Stream.
We've just swamped H's boat. It is absolutely full of it, and we're going to see how it performs. That'd be more than half full, wouldn't it?
Oh yeah, three-quarters.
Three-quarters full of water.
Pretty much under the rim of the hatch.
Yep. Oh, this will be interesting to see how it goes. A lot of weight in there. Goes. Yep.
Oh, she feels sluggish already. Oh.
Look at all the water in the rear well. You are sinking. Oh, that's classic.
I'm sinking and really filling up. I have to close here for a second.
So he's sinking and the water's coming in through the center. Yeah, it is too. The center hatch is totally buried.
Back hatch is under.
I see how I go if I can still drive.
Yep, I'll get out of your way and see what sort of speed you can get up. The rudder, you're going down. He's going under. H is going to sink his boat. The Titanic.
Alright, let's see if we can rescue her then.
Righto. H has got a bilge pump installed into his kayak.
Very slowly, but she's lifting.
Slowly but surely, it's saving his life. Be interesting to see how that would have worked without the pontoons, you know, to see what sort of a difference that would make.
Yeah.
I think they would help quite a bit. So you can feel it lifting up?
Yep, very slowly though, but I can feel it lifting.
And you've got that hooked up to a battery, do you?
A battery, a hatch.
That uses the same battery that runs the sounder? Yep.